What a day. That's my other name. Babe, I'm just glad it's over. I can hear a cold glass of Chardonnay calling. But it's not over, is it? Not for me. What are you on about? You caught the bad guy! Or did you not notice Detective Cross frog-marching him out of here? Yeah, but Blake's still gone, and it was all because of me. Don't be daft. You didn't kill him! But John wanted Blake to fire me. Not Becky, not you, me. If I wasn't on the show, Blake might still be alive. Forget the glass. I'm sensing this is more of a bottle of Chardonnay situation. Maybe two. You're right. I probably just need some time to relax and process everything. Absolutely. You need some downtime, babe. How about we hit the town? My treat. I know this great drag place just around the corner. Can't we just hang at my place instead? I don't know if I want to deal with other people right now. No problem. I still got some stuff to pack up, so I'll meet you out in the parking lot in 10. Reminder, we still haven't found your car keys, Honor. Damn, I forgot about that. Casey, can we make it 20? Sure, I've been stuck here for hours already. What's another 20 minutes? Maybe you dropped your keys in here. Shall I scan the room for them? It's worth a try. You do know what keys actually look like now, right? Only one way to find out. We can question Becky as well. Oh, hey, Honor. John will be down at the station with Detective Cross by now. Wonder how the interrogation's going. I was on to him from the start. As soon as I came into the break room, I was like, he's the murderer, but no one wanted to listen to me. Seriously, Honor, sometimes it's exhausting being right all the time. Yeah, it must be awful. It's so unfair. Everyone knows the show is ruined now that Blake's gone, and so I'll probably never get my Starshine Award. And I missed my party. This day has been a total disaster. I just want it to be over.
You know, we're free to leave, right?
I bet you could still make that party. I could, but I've already missed the paparazzi opening window. It'd just be a waste of time. I thought you went to these parties to meet people, not just to get photographed. You think getting anywhere in Hollywood is about networking? It's all about the column inches, Honor. You go to a party, get snapped looking glam on the way in, then get snapped again on the way out, making sure not to look too sloppy, of course. Get a snap the next day with a giant coffee and huge sunglasses, and you got a double-page spread in celeb life. Or, you could just marry some rich guy and step all over the people who spent years working towards their dream, but you'd know more about that than me. Why are you so obsessed with getting a Starshine Award? You know you're a good actress, you don't need an award to prove it. That award is my dream! I've wanted to win Best Actress since I was a little girl, and I'm not gonna give up now. Don't you think it's a little unhealthy to focus on it like you do? It's healthy to have goals, Honor. I know I'm a good actress, but I want everyone else to know. I want to be able to shove that award in their faces and say, see, I made it. Yep, sounds totally healthy to me. I think this is where I actually have to be to investigate things, so what if we do go to the parking lot? Guess KC must still be packing up. And we can't leave until we find your car keys. Well, I'm pretty sure I didn't drop them out here. They must be inside somewhere. And we can't investigate. Okay, good to know. Actually, before I go waltzing off, we worked through a lot of great episodes in here, and Blake was always ready to talk if I needed something. Now, I know it's the same room, but it feels so different. Understandable. Many things have been moved. I detect 4,913 differences in object position and orientation since my last scan. Cross must have had a team in here to collect any last pieces of evidence. At least they've finally taken Blake away. He deserves some peace. But we can investigate some more. We got some nice solemn music here. Oop. I believe that's right, because they can extend up to there, and that's definitely part of it, so it'd have to go down here, and then potentially... Okay, so it can actually fill in that one too. And actually, this is 6, so... Well, maybe not on that, but this is definitely A1. What this is definitely the two, and then there's the three. We can do that. Nope, that's a four. Ba-ba-da-ba. Keep it there. We'll do that and that. There's our two. Four. Two. There we go. A paper? Oh, photographs. I don't want your. Polaroid. Cross must have missed it when he took the rest of the evidence. Wait a second, didn't Blake mention photographs on that audio tape? They were using them to blackmail him. The photograph seems to show two people engaged in some form of wrestling? Oh, God, they're not wrestling, they're... I'll explain later. So who are the two people in the picture? Obviously that's Blake, so I guess that's his... Wait a second, that's not his wife? No wonder he didn't want these pictures to get out. A scandal like this could have ruined him. There's something written on the other side. Get rid of Honor Mizrahi, or this goes public. That confirms it. Blake was blackmailed into firing me. Detective Cross can add that to the list of charges against John. I don't get why he hated me so badly. According to his letters, he was upset about recent episodes on the show. True, but he was so excited to meet me and Becky. He didn't seem to hate me at all. It just doesn't make sense. Honor, wait, I just ran a comparison on the writing from the back of the photograph. It doesn't match the handwriting on John's letters. You're saying he could be innocent? I don't think I'm qualified to make that judgment, but I don't believe he took this photograph. And if he wasn't the one blackmailing Blake, he may not be the killer after all. We have to take this to Detective Cross. Blake's murderer is still out there. And that's the last thing in the office. Let's go back to the set, because we still need to look for our car keys. Are they in the camera? Anything up yonder? Oop. Alright, so we got the tripod. And that's it. Alright, bottom of the tripod. And that's this row done. What else we got? 512. Easy. Nope, that's out. There we go. 4411 2334. Yeah, that checks out. That works. Oops. And that's that column. Both of these are actually gone. That's not a thing that can be there. That's possible, so I'll just leave that there. That's done. It's A1 for sure. That's a 1. That makes that the 1. Here's a 3. So the 2 for this column is right over there somewhere. There's our 1. The rest of this column is done. This is not a thing. Therefore, 2 and 1, which probably means bop. Car key! A rank. One more left. Hey, you actually found them. I did. As Bogey once said, I think this could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship. Bogey? Yeah, Humphrey Bogart? Don't tell me you don't know Casablanca. Casablanca, the largest city of Morocco. First settled in the 7th century. Not the place, the movie. It's a classic. I don't think I've ever watched a movie before. You'll love it. As soon as we get out of here, we're watching it together. Can I present things to Becky? Hey, watch it! One slip and I end up a brunette. I thought John was a fan? Why was he sending hate mail? Seems he didn't like the way the show was going. One of different writers, I guess. Why do all these freaks think we owe them something? Don't they realize they're watching our show? Hey, is that a Starshine Award? Let me see that. Oh, it's just for best new show. Forget it. Look, I found my car keys. What do you want, a medal? No, it's just I've been looking for them all day, and it was this whole thing, and the scout was trying to help, and... You know what? Never mind. Doesn't matter. You're so weird. I just found this Polaroid of Blake. Did you know he was having an affair? No, but I can't say I'm surprised. He never did keep his promises. Like the time he promised me I'd win Best Actress in my first year on the show. Shouldn't you get that to the police or something? Oh god, I don't want to see that thing ever again. Really? But it's a tiny version of you! I'll admit, I am pretty cute in miniature. What if break room? KC said he'd meet me in the parking lot. I shouldn't keep him waiting. There you are! I can't wait to pour the drinks, put on some music, and relax. Maybe we can still salvage what's been, let's face it, a bloody awful day. About that can't wait. You're flaking on me! Sorry, I need to talk to Detective Cross. I found something, and I think John is innocent after all. Don't worry about him. He'll be fine in a jail cell for one night. It'll just remind him of his basement. I'm being serious, KC. I feel terrible. I convinced Cross to arrest him, and now he's out there on his own, probably handcuffed to a table. How would you like it? Not exactly my scene, but someone says I should be less picky. Sorry, I don't mean to be such an ass. It's just I've barely seen you outside work lately. I miss our catch-ups. I know, divorce isn't as simple as they make it seem on TV. There's always something to sign or some lawyer to talk to. How about tomorrow? We can do the whole drinks and music thing. Maybe watch a movie? Would you believe Scout's never seen Casablanca? Play it again, Scout! I'm sorry, KC. I like the equipment to display moving pictures and— Oh, no, I didn't mean— You know what? Don't worry about it. You two had better go free your little lost boy. If he is innocent, he needs someone like you on his side to show him the way back to Neverland. Casey's theme is pretty rad. I thought you were running off to save John. Are you sure you don't mind canceling tonight? It's fine. This is just the downside of being friends with someone who's nice, I suppose. Hey, I balance you out. I'm the yin to your yang, the sunny to your share. Trying to imply that share isn't the nice one. Careful, or there might be another murder on the cards today. What about you? What are you gonna do now? I'm booked to work a photo shoot tomorrow afternoon. Murder Miss Terry might be on summer break, but this guy here sure as hell isn't. You're in demand. My acting coach always used to say to book all the jobs you can, because one day there won't be any. Oh. Oh, sorry, babe. I didn't mean to... Don't sweat it. I'm happy for you, really. At least things are going well for one of us, right? I wonder if they'll cancel the show now that Blake's gone. I'm not sure. He was the creator. I can't imagine Murder Miss Terry without him. But it was doing well in the ratings, and it makes a lot of money for the studio. I wouldn't be surprised if they find a way to keep it going. I just don't know if I could handle another year of Becky without you around. You know, you could probably get your job back. Blake only fired you because he was being blackmailed. Maybe, but it doesn't feel like now's the time to ask. Oh, sorry, I know Blake's not even in the ground yet, but could you possibly reverse the last decision he made? Thanks. Yeah, that'd be cold, even for you. Hey, I'm not cold, I just take a while to warm up, but I'm room temperature at least. Blake worked so hard to get that award, and then it gets used to... Well, it's kind of ironic, don't you think? Why is everyone ganging up on the poor Alanis like about that? On poor Alanis about that? Who cares what the dictionary definition of ironic is? Dictionaries are for pedants and mouth breeders. Sorry, you were saying? Didn't you win one of these awards for hair and makeup a couple years back? I did indeed, and if you could bring that up again next time we're in conversation with a handsome single man, I'd appreciate it. Look at all this hate mail John sent. He complained about the writing, the directing, the set design. Well, last season wasn't our best. I can kind of understand someone getting mad about it. There's a letter here about how he thought the makeup in one episode made Miss Terry look like a clown that got stuck in a blender. That maggot could bloody rot in his cell! Take a look at these photos. Oh god, who is that Blake? They're naked! Why in God's name are you carrying that around with you? We found it in Blake's office, and there's more. Please tell me you aren't about to pull out a sex tape. No, just look at the photo again. Fine, but I'm sending you the bill for my therapist. That doesn't look like Blake's wife. Because it's not. This is how Blake was getting blackmailed. Bloody hell!
Still, it's not a surprise he was up to no good. What powerful man in this town isn't? They forced him to fire me, and when he tried to call the police, they killed him. I can't believe John was capable of all that. He seemed so harmless. That's where it gets interesting. Scout says that this isn't John's handwriting. The blackmail was nothing to do with him. And that's why you're going, to show this to Cross. Yeah, you're right. This is important. Go on then, stop hanging around here and go rescue the poor sod. Good news, I found my car keys. Well, Scout did. That's great. Now you can go be all Justice League and save the poor innocent victim. Justice League? Isn't that something from a comic? Maybe John wasn't the real nerd after all. What? I just like Wonder Woman, okay? Alrighty, I think I need to... Oh, there we go. Just back out of the main map. It's been years since I was in here. See that gum on the wall behind the desk? I stuck that there 15 years ago. You spent time in the police station? Not in the way you're thinking. My dad used to work here. Oh, that could be to our advantage. Having an ally in the police could... Dad passed away, Scout. A long time ago. We're on our own here. Speaking of which, John's probably alone in the interview room with Cross right now. Keep quiet. We might be able to hear what's going on. Telling you I wasn't there.
Think you're tough, Redfern, but I'm gonna get you to crack, even if it takes all night.
Honor, Detective Cross is gonna crack John. We have to stop him. Shh, he'll hear us. Hi, Detective.
You? What are you doing here?
I found new evidence. It's...
Hand it in at the front desk, okay? I'll get to it in the morning.
But I...
Maybe you haven't noticed, but I'm busy right now. If you want to talk, come back tomorrow. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Damn it, he's locked the door. Hey, open up! You got the wrong guy in there! If Cross won't do his job, we'll just have to do it for him. What are you suggesting? All the case evidence is behind the front desk, right? Let's take another look. We must have missed something. Behind the desk? Behind the desk? What if someone sees us? Let me worry about that. Can you try scanning the murder weapon again? I can conduct a micro-level scan, but it will take some time.
Behind the front desk, huh? Ah. Pictures. Lovely. But what about this? Anything over here? Nothing over here? That's a bummer. Anything on the floor? Nope. Alright, let's get to it. 15s! Oh boy. Alright, let's get to filling these out. There we go. We'll just top those off real quick. And then over here, real quick. And 11 goes down there, so that's fine. Nope. There we go. This is our 2-in-1 for sure. And then we got 4-in-1. This may look intimidating, but it's not all that bad. Oh wait, no, this one, bit. There we go. Oop. That one ducks out, there we go. Bam. Two there. Our 3, it's another 2. And in order to get 2, 2, just gotta do that. This is our 7, straight up. That's all good there. It's our one, two, two, one, and lastly, but not leastly, bam. It's a thumbprint, a fingerprint. S rank, that was the last puzzle of this episode. What did you find? There are faint marks on the award statue. They're oval-shaped with quite intricate patterns. You mean fingerprints? Ah, of course. I'll update my imaging database. If we find a match for those prints, we'll know who held the murder weapon. But how do we find a match? We don't have any fingerprint records to compare against. The police have a database. It would only have the prints of people who have been arrested before, but it might be worth a try. Good idea. Do you have access to this database? I don't have the password, if that's what you mean. Can't you network with it or something? That's not how networking works, Honor. Besides, I don't have any communications hardware, so I... that's odd. It seems I do have a communications port, but the relevant subroutines are damaged. Can you fix them? I can try. Attempting data recovery. Wait, Scout, what's happening? Boot sequence looks good. How's your memory, clock? Stable at 150 megahertz. I'm reading an average efficiency increase of 1.6% since yesterday. Damn it. Did I do something wrong? No, but I bet Tom that overclock wouldn't be stable. Guess I'm buying lunch today.
We gotta get him ready for another test. We're gonna be here in 10 minutes.
10 minutes? I only just started basic diagnostics.
There's nothing we can do. The administrators want to refocus R&D, then.
Screw the administrators, they can't just change the parameters like this. Sorry, Scout, looks like you're in for a long day. You're back! Thank God, I thought I lost you. What happened? It was an unexpected payload inside the damaged communications code. And in English. I remembered something. There's a bright room, people are arguing. Maybe you died and went to electronic heaven. Is that what people mean when they say to meet your maker? I was just kidding, but I guess in your case, that might actually be true. I wish I could remember more. Do you think there might be other memories you haven't found yet? It's possible, but I have no way of knowing where they are or what might trigger them. If there's more to uncover, we'll find it together. I promised I'd help you, and I mean it. Thank you, Honor. I'm so glad I found you. In the meantime, how about that communications code? Can you access the police computer? Yes, I think I have restored that functionality. Give me a moment to make a connection. Alright, we're gonna have to get through these pretty quickly. Solve these puzzles without the use of X or hints. Look out for lines that only have one solution. Any errors will incur a time penalty. So that's that. These are connected. And bam, bam, bam. Bummer. Five, easy. Five, two, three, then, 2, 2, 5, 3, 1. There we go. Not too bad. I found a match for the fingerprint. Well, don't keep me waiting, Scout. Who is it? A man called Frank Pritchell. Who? 34 years old, prior arrest for assault and extortion, although all charges were dropped. There is a photograph attached to the file. You may want to see this. He looks familiar, but something's not quite... Oh my god, it's Tully! I almost didn't recognize him with red hair. That explains the bottle of hair dye. He must have had it in case he needed a quick disguise. He threw on a pair of overalls and made up a story about working on the set. Even the whole stupid thing was probably just an act. He was there to blackmail Blake! Which did not go according to plan. As we heard on the tape, Blake threatened to call the police. So Frank grabbed the closest thing to hand, one of the awards from behind Blake's desk. But now we know who you are, Frank, and we're coming for you.
Man, do I need a coffee.
I have a coffee pot, you want that?
You're still here? Don't you have someplace to be? You just aren't gonna leave me alone, are you? Coffee!
But it is important. Okay.
How's the interview going? The guy's driving me crazy. I don't know how he does it, but he's clammed up tighter than a rhino in a wetsuit.
I know why he's not talking.
Why? Because I'm not going hard enough?
No, he's not talking because he's innocent.
Are you serious? An hour ago you wanted me to throw the book at him.
I've been trying to tell you since we got here.
How many times have I got to tell you? You're not a real detective. You can't walk in here and expect me to overturn hours of work just because you've changed your mind. Everything I've seen points to John. Unless I've missed something, this case is closed.
We found evidence that-
I told you, put it on the front desk. I'll get to it tomorrow.
But you need to see this now.
What could possibly be that important?
Fingerprints. I didn't want to believe it either, but I was wrong. We found fingerprints on the murder weapon.
Fingerprints?
They match a police file on a man called Frank Pritchell. Better known to us as Tully. He was disguised, but it's him.
How did you lift the prints? The lab told me they don't have a slot for hours.
Scout did a micro-level scan of the award. Once I had an image of the prints, I searched the police database for-
You hacked into the police computer? I should have you both arrested.
For solving your case? Get your priorities straight, detective. Frank Pritchell killed Blake, and he's still out there somewhere. Wait a second, where are you going?
We've got Pritchell's address on file. I've got to collar the guy before he leaves town. If he gets away now, the chief is going to bust me down to traffic.
What about us? We found the evidence, we-
Absolutely not! You stay here. And I mean it this time. Don't move until I get back.
I assume we'll be ignoring his instructions as usual. You catch on pretty quick, Scout. The detective left the station in a hurry, but flashing lights and a screaming siren aren't hard to follow. As I drove, my mind turned over the day's events. Blake's death, Scout's appearance, John's arrest, Frank's guilt. It seems like the whole world was turning inside out, a dizzying whirlwind with me at the center. Up ahead, I saw Cross pull up to the curb outside an apartment block, Frank's place. There was a crowd of people gathered outside. A yellow cordon fluttered in the breeze. Something wasn't right. Frank Pritchell was dead. They said it was suicide. A note in his apartment said he hadn't meant to kill Blake. Things got out of hand. He couldn't live with himself. The usual stuff. It tied everything up neatly enough for the police. Case closed. But it wasn't enough. Not for me. I wanted answers. I wanted to know why I was involved. And then? Then I wanted out. To run away, regroup, and salvage whatever was left of my life. Little did I know, the universe had a different plan for me. Case closed.
Beh?
Alright, that's case one over and done with. We're gonna move on to case two next time.